and only enter and exit during applause or a break in the program. Thank you, and enjoy the performance.
Kids and nieces and nephews. Hi, I'm Eric Logan. I'm on the board of Hochstein and very honored to serve with people who really love and care about the mission and the vision of Hochstein. More importantly, the staff and faculty, falling in love with them as they make this mission and vision possible and present and real. And then finally, but not least, if you're like me, when I used to come here with my grandkids and sit with the little singers as they were learning their pieces, or sit with the youth singers, or the young voices as they grew up, you fall in love with all the kids, and you fall in love with the parents and grandparents and aunts and uncles and all of those folks as well. And I know you've experienced that. And that's why you're here, and you know you're in for a wonderful, wonderful time. So, welcome to Hochstein's Concert of Holiday Voices. Let's welcome them on stage.
So we're back. And we're streaming live, right? So is this Doug up there? Doug, who's waving to us? Doug, I want to tell you that we have all sorts of people from everywhere here, right? So I thought that these people should tell you where people are watching.
Welcome.
You people who are watching. So who has fun? Gaudete means rejoice. And this is basically a song that is from the medieval Latin. And before the 1500s, people sang it. And then a bunch of people wrote it down. And here it is. It's a prayer. It's a Christ is born. Rejoice.
Thank you.
causa per frenzito, unde lux de sota salus invenito.
Thank you.
So that was the Hochstein Singers. And that was, this morning was the first time you played that, right? Almost. So we're fortunate to have extra people, not just our excellent accompanist, Yasko Kelly, but Alex Nick, whoa, and Mr. Maddie and John Maddie, whoa. So, good guys, thank you. So you see these little people down here? They're the Hochstein Singers. We even had Hochstein Singers on the stage for 2 years, right? Mrs. Shana Davenport Kohler, and she is awesome. And she's new. And this is the first time she and the little singer, she has ever been on this stage before. And there you go. Thank you.
Thank you.
So, how do you like our new outfits?
And the Hochstein Little Singers outfits.
Thank you.
Lift Every Voice and Sing will be our national hymn. Not our national anthem, we have a national anthem. But we're hoping that it will be a national hymn. It's been proposed to our federal legislature by our legislator called Clyburn, James Clyburn, yes. And it's just being put on hold. But in the meantime, we've learned the first verse, and we hope that you'll sing the first verse along with us because it's in your program. And then you'll hear, after the holidays, next concert, you'll hear the second verse. And then hopefully you'll sing both of those with us. And then when that third verse comes in June, and we sing that whole last thing, you're going to all sing together, I hope. And we'll know this hymn by the time it's our national hymn. And we hope it is, because it tells the whole story of, the two men who wrote this song were brothers. And they wrote this for a morning assembly every single day in a segregated South in 1900. And so those kids sang this, and they owned it, and we're going to own it by the end of the year. Here we go. Please, when the second time comes, would you stand? Because you have to practice, because we're going to sing the Hallelujah chorus in a while, right? So yeah, if you would just stand up there and sing this with us the second time through. That's appropriate. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi. So, three songs by Mark Twain, and they all tell us a thing that we should learn, and we are going to sing them as a suite because they're really short. Hopefully you will understand their words. If you don't, afterwards say hey, and maybe we'll have people tell you what they said. Okay? Because we have masks on and we understand that. So don't clap in the middle, because that's what you do when you have a suite that's all by the same composer and the same, like, if it was a symphony, you would clap in the middle of movement, right? So here we go. Mark Twain, he was funny. So hope you noticed that. Yeah, these people are pretty great. Can you tell?
performances. They're in there somewhere. There are also a whole bunch of things in there that say thank you to people. And Hochstein, this beautiful place doesn't just happen, right? It's supported by an incredible administration. It's got all sorts of people who are just paying attention and doing everything they can possibly do to make this look easy. It's not easy, right? So take a look at all those people, and later on you're going to get to see Dr. Quackenbush sing Halloween chorus with us. So she's our president, and this is her last year. So I'll point her out when she comes up here. Yes, I'm thrilled with that, right? So, yeah, so if you are one of those parents or one of those people who have sung Hallelujah Chorus, be thinking about, oh, I want to come up here and sing it. And I don't know the music right anymore, and we will hand you the music also, ha-ha. So please come up and show these kids how Hallelujah Chorus happens with adults, and we love to sing still, even if we're old, right? And yeah. Thank you. this, it's over. Thank you for coming. And have happy holidays and all those things. And come back to our concerts, because you'll watch as these people grow, not just taller, but grow in every kind of music part of them. And it'll be just as joyful, I hope. So, and meet your kids socially distanced. And you could go outside and, don't have them go outside, but yeah, stay apart, because we don't have any reception or anything afterwards, I'm sorry to say. Because, okay, here we have now survived the pandemic, right? And you've been really glad about it. But it's not over. So keep being vigilant with the rest of us as we wear our masks proudly for the June concert also, right? So thanks for coming.